Bam, it's true. Well, we just got done finding slopes of curved functions, curved lines, curved graphs, whatever you want to call them, at a particular point. Now what we want to do is expand that just a little bit and actually find some derivatives. And we're going to do two examples. We're going to use the same two functions that we used in my previous video. But we're not going to find a slope at a given point. We're going to find something that's even better. We're going to find a derivative, which is going to be a new function, a derivative of the original one, that will tell us very, very quickly the slope at any given value of x. So if we want to find the slope, if we have a curve and we want to find the slope at 3 or 4 points and not just one, we want to find the derivative. And then we can take that derivative and plug in x equals 2, plug in x equals 5, plug in x equals whatever, and just like that we'll have the slope of the original function and not have to go through the whole derivative process for every single point. So, a derivative is a function in which you can plug in any value of x which is in the original function's domain to find the slope of that original function at the value of x. Now, this is what we just got done doing in my previous video, finding the slopes of tangent lines, and we're still going to walk through the same process. But see, in the original video, they were given us specific values of a in which or at which they wanted us to find slope. Well, now we want an expression that'll find us slope, you know, at any given value of x, you know, pretty much instantaneously. So we don't want to find the slope at a particular value of a. We want a derivative which is going to tell us the slope no matter what the x value is, as long as it's in the domain of the function. And thus we can't call it the slope of the tangent line. Nope, we're going to call it derivative, or f prime of x. So we're going to be given a function, we're going to run it through basically the difference quotient, we're going to find a limit as h approaches 0, and that will be the derivative of the original function. That derivative will tell us the slope of the original function at any given value of x. Very, very cool. If you're kind of a math nerd like I am. First, we're two examples. We're just going to find the derivative of two functions. First one being f of x is equal to 2x squared minus 3x plus 1. Now, we're going to be some algebra involved. Lots of steps. Be careful of your signs. Be careful with your parentheses. And when you're done, just before you go to find the limit as h approaches 0, a lot of cancellation is going to happen, and then hopefully you get your final answer. So, which, you know, is correct. We all get answers, just not always right. Hopefully we do in this video. So, f prime of x, or the derivative of f, is equal to, again, careful with the notation. So, f of x plus h. So 2 times something squared minus 3 times something plus 1, that's the first term of our numerator, minus, again, 2 times, well, it's f of x plus h. Let me go ahead and just plug that in. Everywhere there's an x, put in x plus h. And then the second term of the numerator, it's f of x plus h minus just f of x. In other words, just copy this function down again. So 2x squared minus 3x plus 1 all over h. Okay? So we have x plus h. Squared. If you often mess up taking a binomial and squaring it, write it twice, distribute it together, and make sure you get that middle term. This is going to be, forgot the limit. F prime of x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0. That's like biggest concept or biggest point of this question. Let h equal 0, or approach 0. So the limit as h approaches 0 of, take this and distribute it out, we have 2 times x squared plus 2xh plus h squared, if you carefully distribute that binomial together with itself, and then take the negative 3 and distribute it through, so negative 3 times x is negative 3x, negative 3 times h is negative 3h plus 1, Now we're going to take this negative and distribute it through the second term of the numerator. If you had not used those parentheses when you did substitution, your problem's going to fall apart because you'll have sign errors all over the place. Negative 2x squared. Negative times negative is positive 3x. And negative 1 all over h. Woo! Okay, lots of writing. Take this 2 and distribute it. Please make sure that you keep working through the notation. Keep the limit notation going through. You will get to some point in calculus where the problems become very, very long if you don't already think this is long enough. And the sloppier you are with your notation, the easier it is to forget what you've done or make a careless mistake. So 2x squared plus 4x h plus 2 h squared minus 3x minus 3h plus 1 minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 1 all over h. Now at this point, we still have h in the denominator. We need to let h approach 0. This has to cancel out. Otherwise, well, it will cancel out through this process. If it doesn't, you've made a mistake somewhere. Now at this point, I've done lots and lots and lots of expansion, but a lot of stuff now we're going to start canceling out. And it needs to, you need to cancel enough out. If you do all your cancellation, combine all your like terms, and you get to a point where you cannot factor the numerator to get the h and the denominator to cancel out, you need to go back through your work and see where you've made a mistake, because you should get to a point where that denominator, after factoring, will cancel. 2x squared, negative 2x squared cancels. What else do we got? Negative 3x and positive 3x. We've got positive 1 and negative 1. And you see, all my terms that are left have an h in them. That's a good sign. So we have the limit as h approaches 0 of 2h squared. Let's see, you're making sure I don't make a mistake. Plus 4xh here and minus 3h. All over h. That, with these three terms in the numerator all having a value of h in them, becomes limit as h approaches 0. Take out the h, the one h that they all have in common, and you get 2h squared divided by h is 2h, 4xh divided by h is 4x, and 3h divided by h is minus 3. All over h. Now look, see, I told you to cancel out. The h in the denominator cancels out. So I can just take the value of 0, plug it into this expression, and we get the limit as h approaches 0 of 2h plus 4x minus 3 is 2 times 0 plus 4x. Minus 3, of course this is 0, so this is, the expression that's left is my derivative. F prime of x is equal to 4x minus 3. That is my derivative. Now what I can do with this, if I want to find the slope of this parabola at an x value of 0, just plug in 0, and it would be negative 3. If I want to find the slope of this parabola at the x value of 2, plug in 2. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 minus 3 is 5, and I just found the slope at two points along that parabola pretty much right off the top of my head using the derivative. One more example. Bam! This stuff is awesome! Last example. Function has a square root symbol in it, so I'm probably going to have to rationalize the numerator as I find the derivative. So find the derivative of f of x equals the square root of x minus 1. Well, the derivative of a function is equal to f of x plus h, or the limit, as h approaches 0, don't forget that again, of f of x plus h, so the square root of something minus 1 minus, well, just f of x, so just copy the function down. And again, the f of x plus h is, well, right there. Take out the x, plug in x plus h. Over h. Okay, well, just got a lot of arithmetic to do, or algebra, to get the numerator rationalized and hopefully get to some point where I can get rid of that h in the denominator. So we're going to multiply top and bottom by the conjugate. Just change the little sign of the binomial. So top and bottom by the square root of x plus h minus 1 plus square root of x minus 1. I don't know why I just put those parentheses in there. I'm not going to do anything anyway. Okay, distribute. Okay, doing this very, very slowly and carefully. Make sure I don't make any mistakes. Hopefully you're doing the same thing. Square root of x plus h minus 1 times the square root of x plus h minus 1. When you multiply square roots, they cancel each other out. So we just get x plus h minus 1. Just going to put the parentheses around that to highlight that was the first term. Now, I've got this square root times this square root, which is positive, and I've got the exact same square root here times this same square root. And except now I've got a minus sign. This is a difference of squares pattern. A minus B times A plus B. When you multiply that pattern together, the middle term cancels out. So I'm going to skip that step just because of how much writing I'm going to do to finish this. So we have square root of x plus h minus 1 times the square root of x plus h minus 1 equals. And then the positive and the negatives, the two terms cancel out in the middle. And then we get negative times a positive, so negative, parentheses, square root of x plus 1 times square root, square root of x minus 1 times square root of x minus 1. Again, the square roots are going to cancel each other out because you're multiplying the exact same thing together. Let's see here. Square root of 3 times square root of 3 is square root of 9, and the square root of 9 is still 3. Okay, so they do cancel each other out. So minus x minus 1, that binomial that's inside the square roots function that just canceled itself out. Over h times all of this, so h times the square root of x plus h minus 1 plus the square root of x plus 1, minus 1, distribute this negative sign, and cancel some stuff out now. We have the limit as h approaches 0 of x minus x. Well, that's going to cancel out. Negative 1 minus negative 1 is negative 1 plus 1, which cancels out. And we have h over h times the square root of x plus h minus 1 plus the square root of x minus 1. The h's cancel out, because it's just h times all of this, and we get 1 on the numerator. Well, now I can take and actually find the limit as x approaches 0. I can take 0 and plug it in here now and not get a denominator which is 0, that's undefined. So we let h approach 0, and we get 1 over the square root of x plus 0, because we're letting h approach 0, minus 1 plus square root of x minus 1. Extend that fraction a little bit. Now, 0 minus 1, of course, is negative 1. Now I can actually put these square roots together because of exactly the same thing on the inside, x minus 1. They both have the same index of 2. So we just get, 1 over 2, because, 1 plus 1 is 2, square root of x minus 1. So the derivative is f prime of x, or the derivative of x, is equal to 1 over 2 times the square root of x minus 1. And with all the algebra involved here, hopefully your teacher is not going to make you rationalize the square root out of the denominator, and they're happy that you've got the derivative. You can take any value of x now that, you know, for which this is defined and the original function is defined, plug in any value of x, boom, you've got the slope of this original function. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework, and thank you for watching.